Hello everyone, I'm Glancia Fernandez from the Department of Commerce, Milagres College, Mangalore. Today I'll be speaking on the concept measures of variation or dispersion. So let us know what do you mean by variation or dispersion. The property of deviation of values from the average is called as variation of dispersion. Though the values cluster around an average, most of them differ from it. So there are some of the examples. Variations in the frequency distribution of age of students of a class is less than the variation of distribution of age of employees of a factory. In this category of sum, the variation of dispersion will be applied differently. There are various methods in variation and dispersion. The methods are as follows: range, quartile deviation, which is called as QD, mean deviation, MD, standard deviation, SD. We will know about standard deviation. Before going for standard deviation problems, let us know the formulas. The formulas are displayed over here. The first formula is applied for a raw data kind of a sum. Standard deviation formula goes like this: square root of summation x minus mean whole square divided by n. Remember, the n term should be in small letter, that is for a raw data. When it is a discrete or continuous series sum, which is nothing but comes under tabulated data, the formula will change. That is square root of summation f into x minus mean whole square divided by capital letter N. That is the difference for the raw data and for a tabulated data sums. Next we have computation of standard deviation formulas. The formula goes like this: standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation x square divided by small letter n minus summation x divided by n whole square. This is for a raw data, whereas for tabulated data this formula differs. Only the difference is the frequency come in between. Formula will be standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation fx square divided by capital letter N minus summation fx divided by N whole square. This will be applied for a tabulated data. There is the other formula for assumed mean method, whereas we will be taking one of the assumed value and the formula will be different. The formula goes like this: standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation u square divided by n minus summation u divided by n whole square, which is applied for a raw data. Now let us know what is the formula for u. U formula will be x minus a. X, the data given in the question, A, which is nothing but the assumed value. Tabulated data, the formula differs again. As the previous formula says, frequency will be the addition. So the formula will be standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation fu square divided by capital N minus summation fu divided by N whole square. Step deviation method, this is the other method for a standard deviation, whereas we have one more term which is called as C, and when C is applied, the formula goes this way: standard deviation, which is equal to C into square root of summation fu square divided by n minus summation fu divided by n whole square. And the formula for u will differ here, that is x minus a divided by C, whereas in the previous question we had u which is equal to x minus a. In this, the formula differs in the case of u also. Let us go with the problem. Here is the question: following are the heights of 5 children. Find the standard deviation. Height is given 130, 137, 136, 142, 135. This sum is purely of a raw data where only one information is given. There is no frequency. Now take the values as x value, then apply your first formula, that is standard deviation formula. Standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation x minus mean square, close the bracket, divided by n. Apply this formula first. Once you apply this formula, from this formula we require mean. So there is a mean formula which have done in the mean classes. So mean formula, which is nothing but summation x divided by n. We know the values of x. Add all the x values, we get 680. Count how many values are given. Here 5 values of heights are given of 5 children. So 5 children's values are given. Summation x total, we get it as 680. 5 counts are there, divide by 5, you get the answer as 136 centimeters. Then apply to your standard deviation formula. Your formula goes this way. Summation x minus x bar or mean square divided by n. We know the answer of x as 680. Summation square we need to find out. So go to your table. There is a x value. Go to the formula. See, in the formula we require x minus x bar square. Before going directly to x minus x bar square, find the part of it. That is x minus x bar or mean. So mean value we got it as 136. X values are given in the first column. 130 minus 136 will give you minus 6. 137 minus 136 will give you 1. 136 minus 136, 0. 142 minus 136, 6. 135 minus 136, minus 1. Next, according to the formula, get the square. That is x minus x bar whole square. Minus 6 into minus 6 will give you 36. 1 into 1, 0 into 0, 0. 6 into 6, 36. Minus 1 into minus 1, 1. So the total of last column will be 74. Apply to your formula. Square root of 74 divided by 5 will give you 14.8. The answer will be 3.85 centimeters. This is the answer of standard deviation. Now same problem is applied with the assumed mean. Whereas I've explained you in the formula to take a assumed mean as a value to apply for this kind of a formula. This formula is nothing but the step deviation formula. Let us know the formula. Standard deviation, which is equal to square root of summation u square divided by n minus summation u divided by n whole square. Before going with the formula, take the terms of this formula. I've told you there is a separate formula for u. The u formula will be x minus assumed mean. In this problem, assumed mean has taken as 135. Select any value from the x column as the assumed mean. We can take it 135, we can take it 136 or any value. I have taken 135 as the assumed mean. The u formula goes x minus a and you get the answers as follows. That is 130 minus 135 will give you minus 5. 137 minus 137 minus 135 will give you 2. 136 minus 135, 1. 142 minus 135, 7. 135 minus 135, 0. The answer of u column is 5. Next, according to your formula, the formula says we need u square also. We got the answer of u. We need u square also. So next column should be u square. Multiply minus 5 into minus 5, 25. 2 into 2, 4. 1 into 1, 1. 7 into 7, 49. 0 into 0, 0. The total of u square column is 79. Now go back to your formula. As we have got the answer u square as 79, apply as it is. Summation u square is 79. Number of counts of children are 5. Minus summation u total was 5. Apply as it is, 5 divided by total counts 5 whole square. Square root of 14.8 will be the answer. Take a square root for this. You will get an answer as 3.85 centimeters. As I've told you in the previously for an assumed mean, you can take 135, 136, any values you can take. Here 136, if it is taken, the values will differ. You can see it on the side of this column. The values will not be the same. if you take the assumed mean as 136, the values will be like this, 1, minus 6, 1, 0, 6, minus 1, whereas u square values also differ, the total also will differ. When you apply to the formula, the values will differ. Here you find it in a different way, whereas I've done a calculation separate, 74 minus divided by 5 minus 0 by 5 whole square will give you 14.8, and the square root of this will be the same. Any assumed value, if you take, the value or the answer will be the same. So I've given a note also. If you take a assumed mean as the least value, that is 130, the calculation would be easier. Thank you.